Well, good morning, church family. It is Saturday, May the 2nd, and I hope you are doing well today. It's just another beautiful day today, and I know there's a lot of excitement about the beaches opening and everything, so I hope you are doing well. Had a chance to go to the beach and enjoy it. Be careful still. Still be very precautious about what you do, cautious about what you do, we'll get through this. This season is hopefully will be over within a couple of months. You never know. So, but today's devotion comes out of Jeremiah chapter 30, verses 1 through 10. I'm going to read the verses and then just say a brief word about it. So it's Jeremiah 30, 1 through 10. This is written Israel and Judah, kind of the restoration of beginning the restoration of Israel and Judah and Jeremiah. So here we go. It says, "The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, write in a book all the words that I have spoken to you. For behold, days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will restore the fortunes of my people, Israel and Judah, says the Lord, and I will bring them back to the land that I gave to their fathers, and they shall take possession of it. These are the words that the Lord spoke concerning Israel and Judah. Thus says the Lord, we have heard a cry of panic, of terror, and no peace. Ask now and see, can a man bear a child? Why then do I see every man with his hands on his stomach like a woman in labor? Why has every face turned pale? Alas, that day is so great, there is none like it. It is time, it is a time of distress for Jacob. Yet he shall be saved out of it. And it shall come to pass in that day, declares the Lord of hosts, that I will break his yoke from off of your neck, and I will burst your bonds, and foreigners shall no more make a servant of him. But they shall serve the Lord their God, and David their king, whom I will raise up for them." And then in verse 10 it says, "Then fear not." There's our phrase. "Fear not, O Jacob of my servant, declares the Lord, nor be dismayed, O Israel. For behold, I will save you from far away and your offspring from the land of their captivity." Now listen to this verse. "Jacob shall return and have quiet and ease, and none shall make him afraid." Now there's other translations. The other translations, like it says, "Jacob shall return and have peace and security." And so today, the truth is, through all of this, just like in the time, I think, when God is restoring Judah and Jacob and giving them quiet and ease, God also can give us quiet and ease. He can give you quiet and ease. He can give us peace and security. Now, earlier in the verse, it talked about the men are so distressed that their stomachs are hurting, that they're bent over in agony and in pain. Whenever I was a teenager, I don't know if I was distressed or had that much anxiety, but I remember having just immense stomach pains and stomach aches where I would bend over and I know that there are people today that gets so anxious that their stomach starts churning so much. They get so distressed that they're in agony and that much pain. But I want to encourage you that if you get into God's Word, if you get into the truth of His Word, He said that He will bring you peace and security. Now, the thing is this has to be a daily thing to get into His Word, and He will bring you that quiet and ease. He will give you that peace and security. I believe He will wholeheartedly, just like it says He would do for Judah and Israel, for Jacob, which is Judah and Israel. He will do that for you. I wholeheartedly believe that. He does that for me. I believe He'll do that for you. So please get into His Word so that God can take away that anxiety, take away that stress, and that you can have that quiet and ease. You can have that peace and security because our God is the God that gives that peace and security. Let's pray. God, I just want to thank you for this beautiful day. God, I thank you for the fact of your Son, Jesus, who in Him there is grace and mercy. And God, I just want to praise your name that even though we have anxiety, even though we have stress, we can't control the situations around us sometimes, God, that you can give us that quiet and ease. What a blessing to think about just living, just being where our soul can just breathe and have that quiet and ease or that peace and security. God, my prayer is that today maybe there's someone in here that's listening this morning, Father, that they would get into your word, God, that they would read it, and the truth of your word, God, will massage their hearts and will give them peace and security because you are the giver of peace and security. I love you, Lord. Thank you for this day. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, church family, I love you. I'm praying for you. Remember to get into God's word. It is his truth. Let it just be what you listen to every day, and it will give you that peace and security. He will give you the peace and security through his word, and then also that always in Christ Jesus, there is always hope. So I love you. Have a great day.